he was the great man. So the party which came into power after independence had a great reverence for Gandhi. Now the question arises, when the party in power has great reverence for Gandhi, and the and there is a democracy in our country, the party was elected many times by the votes of this Indian people, then how can we have a non-violent protest movement against that party or against that government which itself has come into power because of these means? So the contradictions begin. So the contradiction, there was a split in the movement. Some say, no, no, this is wrong. How can we? Because now, when Gandhi did this, then the particular form of protest was not there, like voting was not there. There was no democracy. So if there was no democracy, then there was no other means but to organize ourselves, to protest against the government, and that protest should be non-violent. Now we have got a means to protest against the government. If you do not agree with government policies, then we have the right to oust that government. Every 5 years, we have got the vote, and we can oust the government if we do not agree with what the government is doing. When democracy is here, then what is the need for a non-violent protest movement? That is a major philosophical question which has created a split in the movement. So what happened later on, originally, if you know, which culminated in the emergency in 1974, that a point came where it was argued out that these movements, which came only after 5 years, they are not sufficient for expressing our discontent. So we should have different type of things also. And to adapt, at the peak of the movement, it was also argued out that now this type of democracy is not acceptable. We should have what we call the Jan Andolan. We should have a party-less democracy, because party has hijacked this democracy, so we should have a party-less democracy. Nowadays we see that there is a movement for the last 2 years is going on against corruption. They also argue out in the same manner that no, no, even if we have given you vote, even if you are in power, now the janta or the public feel that this is wrong, wrong is being done, so you should listen to us. And we are, what we are doing, we are following Gandhi, because we are doing non-violent protest. The question arises, this conflict is becoming a very important conflict in Indian society and in polity, that those who are in power, all of them give their reverence to Gandhi. All of them give their reverence to Gandhi. All of them believe that they are in power because of Gandhi. Then, and we have given an opportunity to those who are against our ideas, they can oust us in the politics, in the elections. But the question is that whether it is now, how these contradictions can be resolved. Because that is the way, I believe, is a major reason for decline of what we call the Gandhian ideals or Gandhian movement in India, because this philosophical conflict has not been resolved clearly, that how we go about in a free country. In other words, what I'm trying to say is that how Gandhi, which was a philosopher of protest, can be converted into philosopher of power. Whether it is possible to create a society, what we claim it, on the basis of Gandhian principles, whether there can be a state which can call itself Gandhian state, in the sense that those who are in power, they are following Gandhian ideas, whether it is a contradiction in terminology or not, whether what we are thinking, whether, let us assume, imagination, that Gandhi would have been very young, and after independence, he might have been in, stayed here for the last 30 years or 20 years, then how he would have reacted to the whole situation which is now emerging. Whether Gandhi would have protested against the ruling party or not, whether Gandhi would have invented some new weapons to protest against the ruling party or not, we have no idea. We can only imagine about it. So that is the major thing. Whether the Gandhi, who is considered as a philosopher of protest, can be converted into a philosopher of rule or philosopher of power or not. And if it is possible, then how we go about it? Because the party which came into power has a reverence for Gandhi, but is not following Gandhian programs. That we know. That we know. And they have their own valid reasons for that. And they go to public, go to people, and get mandate for that, what they are doing. And people are giving them mandate. The same persons, the same population, which had reverence for Gandhi, they are voting for those persons who are not following Gandhi programs. How can you explain this contradiction? And when democracy, when the public is choosing a particular government, then you have to accept it that the government is right until unless we prove that the elections are totally fake, which is not fake in the case of India, because we know that in the last 70 years, one of the greatest achievements of India is that we have maintained democracy, which has failed in our neighboring countries. Most of the countries which got freedom after 1945, most of the countries degenerated into dictatorship. India is one of the exceptions, a very, very exception, where democracy is still intact and we can have a democratic government. So that is one of the major important issues which I just wanted to point out when we are discussing this, it put it in the context. Secondly, when we are talking about the academic action or academic research on Gandhi, again the question arises, what type of research we are doing? You are more aware about it. Most of the books which are written on Gandhi, out of 100 books, if you say, 70 or 75 books are written on Gandhi's personality or what Gandhi did in his time, not on the Gandhian thought. The Gandhian thought is totally, it is just a recent, I think in 70s and 80s, people have started talking about Gandhian thought. So first of all, if you want to create a very academically relevant and academically very good scholarship on Gandhi, then the necessary thing is that we should forget about Gandhi's personality. We are obsessed with Gandhi's personality, that is our part, that is right also in some context, but if we are obsessed with the personality of a person, then we always forget the ideas of the person. So if we want to develop something, a very rigorous scholarship on Gandhi, then we should talk about his ideas. Like, for instance, we know about it, that there is a very rigorous scholarship of Marx, there is a very, very rigorous scholarship of so many other thinkers, but they never talk about the personality, they talk about the applications. So now the question arises, whether scholars are ready for this or not. Because scholars say that if we do research on this, without mentioning to the ideas of Gandhi, without mentioning the life of Gandhi, then the ideas cannot be explained. Because Gandhi says that there is no difference between what I have done and what I am thinking. Because he is one of the greatest person or rarest person whose thinking, speaking and acting had no difference. And that is the sign of a great person. All of us know that we think something else, we talk something else, and we do something else. That is the characteristic of a common man. So the greatness of Gandhi was this. But if you want to create a scholarship of the highest order, then we have to concentrate only on what he has done and what he has written and how these written words have affected the ideas of the coming age, ideas of those who have followed. So we should dissociate what Gandhi did, whether Gandhi were Gandhi or not, what Gandhi did with his family, what Gandhi did when he was doing in ashrama. We should keep ourselves confined to what Gandhi has written, and then we can come out with certain things which he has not, Gandhian scholars have done, that what is the Gandhian approach towards life. We have a Marxist approach towards life. You call to a Marxist, and Marxist will say, not Marx has done. They will quote Marx, but after Marx, a scholarship of development of the highest order, where we can have a Marxist sense of aesthetics, we have a Marxist sense of science, we have a Marxist approach to everything, whatever under the sun, but we do not have, in comparison, a Gandhian approach to everything. Like, we do not have a Gandhian approach to aesthetics, for instance, a Gandhian approach to appreciate poetry, a Gandhian approach to appreciate literature. We don't have any, we do not have such illuminating articles, research articles which explain what can be seen as Gandhian approach to appreciate literature. But there are thousands of articles which can say that this is a Marxist appreciation of literature. The reason is, after Marx, there are many scholars and academicians who have followed Marxian terminology, Marxian sense, and they created their own literature or aesthetic idea. But in India or abroad, we are still obsessed with Gandhi's personality. We have not got enough scholars yet, after Gandhi died, 70 years have passed, 50 years have passed, that we have developed such scholars who can develop independently in their own subject a Gandhian approach. Like, there is no Gandhian approach, it's a Gandhian approach to study society, Gandhian approach to study literature, Gandhian approach to study science, what is the Gandhi's ideas of science. This is lacking. So what I just wanted to point out, that if we want a scholarship on Gandhi, then we will have no other alternative but to dissociate Gandhi from his personality. We should concentrate only on idea. But it is a difficult task, because in India, it is very difficult to talk of Gandhi's ideas and not talk of Gandhi's personality. When we talk of ideas, we say that how can you are not an authority on Gandhi unless you wear Gandhi, unless you look like Gandhi, unless you do what Gandhi. There are thousands of persons you also encounter, Whenever we talk, they say, no, this is bakwas. You are talking about Gandhi's ideas, what is the relevance of them? We should do what Gandhi has done. So we should go to the village, we should go to schools, we should go to our society and do what Gandhi has done. I am saying that is right, but that's a different point. There are persons who should do it. There are persons who should follow these things. But then forget about Gandhi as a scholar. Then forget about Gandhi and do what Gandhi has done. I am saying that is right, but that's a different point. There are persons who should do it. There are persons who should follow these things. But then forget about Gandhi as a scholar. Then forget about Gandhi as an idea. Because the world is now concentrating on only two things. One, that is that what Gandhi has created a new invention of protest. The whole world is following that while doing protest. The other thing is they are now using Gandhi's ideas in different movements of the world. Different intellectual movement like environmental, like cultural studies, like feminism. They are using Gandhi's ideas to enrich their understanding of this new intellectual movements. So either if we want to establish ourselves as a scholar, then either we should forget about Gandhi's personality, concentrate on his ideas, create such scholarly movement like scholarly associations, scholarly institutes, where only Gandhi's ideas will be discussed, no one will discuss what Gandhi has done. Then only we can go forward towards creating a scholarship on Gandhi. What I am saying is not necessarily that we should create a scholarship on Gandhi, because in India, again, I am telling you time and again, that we are obsessed with Gandhi. We are grateful to Gandhi, we have full reverence to Gandhi, and so we feel that ideas discussion is not so important, but what we are implementing is more important, what we are following is more important. That is, we are obsessed with, we feel like Mahavir. Now, we don't have to discuss what Mahavir has said. What Mahavir has said, we already know. If we follow a few things of Mahavir, if we follow a few things of Buddha in our life, then we think that we have paid more contribution, we have paid our due to that great man. So, in that sense, the greatness of Gandhi is curbing